Hi, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to create or insert a flowchart in several different ways. So the first thing is I'm going to just change the orientation of this page to landscape. So if I go up to layout, along to orientation, click on the drop down and select landscape. Next thing to do is go to insert and go along to smart art, click on the drop down. Go down to hierarchy and you can see you've given a number of different options. Today I'm going to create this flowchart, but you can see here that you've got several other options. Now all the things that I'm going to demonstrate, the tools and tricks, will apply to all the other ones here, but I'm just going to use this example today. So just click on it and as you can see, Word has inserted our flowchart. Now the first thing you'll notice is that if I try to pick this chart up and move it, it's not quite centered in my page. You can't actually move it around, which is a little bit annoying. So to get around that, if you select it, go to Format, go along to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and select In Front of Text. And now you can move it anywhere on your page. If you want it perfectly centered, just select it, again go to Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Middle, and that's perfectly lined up on your page. Now you can see we've got a little arrow here with a little menu box, and all this is just the information for the hierarchy of the different boxes. And as I select a box, you can see there's a selection around this particular entry here. So I'll put in my first bit of text, and you can see it copies it over to here. Now you can just simply go ahead and put all of your different text in if you want to. Now you might be thinking, well that's great, but I don't actually want it to look like this because it's formulated in a slightly different way. That's absolutely fine, and that's what I'm going to show you next. So say for example you don't want this box here, just select it, press delete, and it will disappear. Let's say you wanted to add a box next to this box, then all you have to do is select it and select the plus button and it will insert an additional box. Now the way in which this works depends on which box you've selected. So if I want another box pointing to this point here, above or below this box here, I need this box selected. Then I need to press the add button. But if I decide this is now my fourth box, and I want this fourth box above the fifth box, then just select the box, go to the green arrow, select it, and you can see it's swapping it, select it again, and it will swap it again. And that's how you can change these boxes around. Now, if I want an additional box coming out of this point here, alongside this box, again, select the box, click Add. And once again, it will add a box along this second row. If we want to add additional boxes further on, just select the box you want to add to. Again, add the plus button and you'll add an additional box. When you select a box, you can go up to Smart Art Design here. Now in here, you've got your full customization menu. This element here generally refers to this box here. So if you select a box here and I select Add Shape, it's just going to add another box. So it does exactly the same as the Add button here. Again, if you want to promote a box to raise it higher, you just click Promote left or right or up and down. So if I want the fifth box on this row here, you'll see it goes to this row here. If I want it to go back, demote it, it will go back to the third row. Now in terms of your design, you can edit all of the text and you can change the colour of the entire flowchart, or you can just select different boxes. So if I want to change the font of all of my flowchart, I can simply click on one of the hierarchy boxes, press Command or Control A, and I will have selected all of the boxes in my flowchart. Go to the Home tab, select the font that you want, and then just click on it. And as you can see, all my font has changed. Additionally, we can change the look of this by going up to Smart Art. And you can see we can change the colors. And we have a large variety of colors here. Let's just select this gray. And we can go along to this element here to give us some more 3D effects if that's what we want. And you can see the range that we have here. And there's lots to choose and play around with. So I'm going to stick with this. And as you can see, my text is just a little bit too big. So once again, I'm going to select the top box here, press Command or Control A to select my entire flowchart. Go back up to the Home tab. I'm going to use this Reduce or Decrease Font Size tool here. I'm just going to keep clicking on that till I'm happy. I'm going to actually change this font to this one because I believe that fits my boxes perfectly. Now, if you want further options with regards to color, then once again, select everything, Command or Control A, then go to Format, and go to Format Pane, and then this menu will appear. Make sure you're on Shape Format. Go to the bucket icon, click on Fill, and then you've currently got it selected on Solid Fill. So you can go down to Color. Let's just move this menu in a little bit. Go down to Color, and then you've got a large variety of colors to choose from. Let's just click on the orange. You can see how that's changed. Just deselect it, and then you can have a look to see how that's changed. Once again, if I just select everything, and then I go back over to Shape Options, I can also use a gradient fill. So if I select that, and then at the moment, my gradient stops are all in black and grey colours. The way to change the colours is select a marker, go to Colour, select a colour. You can delete one of the markers by selecting it and clicking on the minus key, and again, changing the colour of that marker to something else. You can see on the left how it's adjusted the boxes, and we can also play around with these customization options too, with the direction of that gradient and also its transparency and its brightness. So let's just click away and see how that's affected our flowchart. The only downside to using this form of chart is that you can't actually put a box coming out from the bottom here. They will always come out of the end here. So if I add a box, it would come out at the bottom. Now you can move the boxes, so I can click on it and move the box, but you can see how that line will adjust. And I cannot click this line and move it. So I cannot get a line to move from this box to this box. However, if that's something that really bothers you and you want to create your own flowchart, if you go to Insert, go to Shapes, and then all the way down the bottom, there's all these different options here. Now you can click on any of these and use them for a flowchart, and I'll show you how they work. I'll click on the first one, and then just click and drag out a box. You can see we now have a box and also a line, and because that line has two yellow markers on it, it means that you can move both of those ends to suit your needs, and you can fully customize the look of this box. Now, in order to create quite a professional flowchart, you would need to ensure that your boxes are the same size and any text inside, again, is the same. So a good idea is to customize this box first and then copy and paste it. Now, all of these shapes come with a border line and with a fill color. Now, because we've got a line here, if I try to take the border line off, it would also take this line off here. So let's change the color of this, click on it, again over to Format Pane and to Shape Options. Solid fill here, you can go to color, select a color. If I click away, you can see there's a border line here. Now, if I select our shape, go to Shape Options and click No Line, you can see that all the lines disappear, which is actually not what we want. So using this technique, you'd have to keep those borderlines, but you can change the color. So select it, again, shape options. It keeps jumping across to text options. And then you can go down to the color and you can select a color of your choice. Once again, as before, you can just put your text in and then select the text by Command and Control A. Go to the Home tab again, use the Increase Font Size tool to increase the font size. And then you can decrease the size of that box if you want to. And again, you can move this anywhere around your page. We can copy and paste this using Command or Control C, deselect it, Command or Control V. Whoops. You need to go back, just press Command or Control Z. Now I find the quickest way to copy and paste is select the item, hold down the Alt key, click and drag. With them both selected, I can click out two more. Now if you want to make sure these are all aligned, you can click and select all three by holding down your Command or Control key, go to Shape Format, go to Align, and distribute them vertically will mean there's equal spacing between them all. And then again, click on the drop down Align to Left. Now those three boxes are all perfectly lined up. If you're happy with where they are, you can group them, but obviously you need to ensure that these lines are exactly where you want them. So we can move the line to the center. We can move this box down. We can move this box and make sure it's aligned with this center one. Clicking on this box and then this box, go to Align, Align to Middle, and those boxes will be aligned. Now you can see that box moved and not this one. So let's go back and we'll select this box and then this box, Align, Align to Middle. Now it's chosen to move that one. That's fine, we can go back and just select them all again. Distribute vertically, again it's moving this box, okay. So what we can do is line that one up perfectly with that, and then we can use our arrow keys and do it that way. Now obviously when I stated about the shortfall of this particular flowchart, it was that you couldn't move a box to the bottom and create that line vertically. Now, again, you're probably looking at this and thinking, well, I can't do that either. But if you move the pointer and then move the pointer again, we can create the style we were looking for. And again, we can move that around to suit our needs. I'm just going to zoom in a bit. I'm going to see if we can line this up perfectly. The trouble with this is that it's not doing its usual thing where generally when it's completely vertical it will click into place, but it won't click. It's just very, very easy to move and nudge. So let's just zoom out, and as I said, you can move that to where you want it. If you want to ensure these are lined up again, just select them all, go to Shape Format, align to center. And those will all be lined up. Now, I'd say from my perspective, this is a little bit more of a clunky way to do it because you do have to move all of these lines and it's really not that easy to do. However, if the other style doesn't work for you and you want a bespoke flowchart and you're not too worried about the lines and actually they need to go everywhere, then actually this is a perfect choice for you. The boxes will align brilliantly with the alignment menu, but you will have to just go back and move all of those individual lines. Once again, you can select all of the boxes and change the look of them together. So again, go to Shape Options and we can go to Gradient Fill. And again, we can have exactly the same look as we have there. Now, of course, what you can do with the first box, if you don't want this line, is you can just simply go to Insert, Shape, use the rectangle, click and drag out a rectangle for the start. Go along and select this one, the height's 1.91. So let's select that, copy it, go back to the rectangle and just paste it into here. Press enter, then go back, copy and paste the height, select the rectangle again, paste that value in, and then you'll end up with exactly the same size box. Then again, just go across to the format shape menu, gradient fill, which it already has, down to the solid line and just change it to black as we did with the others, and then you won't have the little line at the back here. Now again, because we're in Word, always has a downside because you can't type inside a shape. So what we need to do is to go to Insert, Text Box, Draw Text Box, click and drag out the text box. We want to get rid of the background and the line, so select it, go to Shape Format, click on this icon, no outline, click on Shape Fill, no fill, type your word in, select it, go to the Home tab, change the color of it to white, just check the font size of this one, so select it. You can see it's 24 calibri. So again, double click inside, Command or Control A, go to 24 on the font size. We've got it on calibri, and all we need to do is center it. So select it, go to the center text icon, and then to center it to the actual box, select it, hit the Command or Control key, select the box outside. So select the box, Command or Control, select the center box, go to Shape Format, go to the Align tool, align to center, again align, align to middle. And you've got exactly the same box as you've got everywhere else. So that's a way to get around that first box. Now you may want to move this chart, but if you start to move it, you can see I start to move each individual part, which is going to be really annoying if you need to move it to a different part of your page. So a quick and easy way to move it as a whole is select one of the boxes, again using that Command or Control key to select everything, go to Shape Format, go along to Group, select Group, and now you can move your chart anywhere you want. Now you can see I haven't grouped that text, so I've forgotten to do that, so simply go back, Command or Control Z to where it was, and then it ungroups it if you go back enough times, just keep hitting it until it ungroups. If it doesn't ungroup, then just select it all again, go to Group and select Ungroup. But I need to select this text here, Command or Control key, hit the outside box as well, go to Group and then select Group. Now I can select all the other boxes. Oh, let's just go back because that nudged it. There we go. Back up to Group and select Group. And now you can move everything round as one. Now if you want it perfectly centered, select it again, back up to the Align tool and Align to Center. And now they're both perfectly lined up in your page. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.